Welcome to Book Time with Ryan. I am Ryan, and today we have 250,000 subscribers watching. 250,000. It seems like only yesterday I had 422 total subscribers. 250,000. That's beyond my wildest dreams. I never thought this channel would get that successful, but it obviously has. Today I'll be talking about Asleep by Molly Caldwell Crosby. This is the forgotten epidemic that remains one of medicine's greatest mysteries. Awesome book. Oh my gosh, I'm naked in front of all these subscribers, 250,000. And I haven't read this book in days and days and days. I don't remember anything. Ryan, slow down. This is your dream. Control it. But I'm naked and I gained all this weight during COVID. Yes, yes, yes. Everyone did, or a lot of people did. That's okay. You need to trust yourself. Take over your dream. Tell them what you want them to hear.
But there might be kids watching. I'm going to get arrested naked in front of all these kids. Oh my gosh, why?
No, no, no. Set it as an adult. Set it as your adult setting. Nobody else will see it. Start over. Take a mulligan. Do it now.
I finished this book hours ago. It's a great book. I liked it a lot. What started this book for me? Well, my wife and I were watching The Sandman on Netflix. I think it's Netflix. Someone mentioned this book on Twitter, and they said that the sleep in The Sandman was based off of this turn-of-the-century sleeping sickness. And there's this whole epidemic that has been basically forgotten over 100 years ago, and that's what this book's about. So in The Sandman, when everyone falls asleep, that actually happened. Why did it happen? Was it the Sandman? No. It happened because of something called encephalitis lethargica. Now this was happening, this may have happened multiple times throughout history, but this book really covers around World War I. And what happened, people got infections. The flu was going around, the Spanish flu. So people would get infections in their brain and they would have inflammation in their brain. And eventually the inflammation would go away, but it would cause damage. And throughout their lives, they would start to feel more and more of kind of the damage in the brain. They don't know exactly why this happened to some people and not others. They think that the war probably helped spread encephalitis lethargica because soldiers were being taken from battlefield to battlefield to different cities, brought back to England, brought back to London, brought back to Germany and Austria, France, and eventually the United States. And they started seeing a spread of this very interesting, unique disease. So this would cause people to either go to sleep for weeks on end, months on end. They weren't in a coma. They were conscious of things happening. They could respond to different things, but they were asleep. They basically couldn't motivate their body to react. Or they were hyperactive and they couldn't get to sleep and they basically burned themselves out. They would gradually lose more and more control of their body parts and get really tense and locked up and basically would kind of be trapped in their bodies. And this is a time period where science didn't really know what to do. They didn't know if this was a kind of mental disease, if this was a physical disease. So they could treat the mind or they could treat the brain. And it was a time where psychoanalysis and neurology were really kind of defining themselves. This book covers different case studies that happened throughout the years, all the way up until the last person who had the epidemic version of encephalitis lethargica died in 2002. They were in an institution for 70 years because as they got more and more disabled, they lost more and more control over their impulses and they could become dangerous and they would take it out on people and hurt people, hurt themselves. And they were aware they were doing it. They were aware it was wrong. They felt bad about it, but they couldn't stop it. There's an example in here in a case study of a girl who was committed to a hospital and pulled one of her eyes out one night and just kind of was matter of fact about it, freaked out the nurses, and then the next night she pulled out the other eyeball. Didn't really think anything of it. Understood that she shouldn't have done it, but she couldn't stop herself. So there's a lot of stories like that. That's actually pretty extreme. There's a lot of stories in this book that are just cases of people coming down with Spanish flu and then years later having the effects of this epidemic, which they weren't aware of when they got it. Adults were affected in similar ways, but they could recover. About a third of them died. About a third recovered with no real long-term damage. And about a third of them recovered, but with major long-term disabilities. For children, it was much worse. For children who caught encephalitis lethargica, they rarely recovered, and it affected, it changed who they were for the rest of their lives because their brains were much less developed, and the damage at a young age was not corrected or repaired as they got older. So they just had these issues, and it was really sad. So the doctors in here are trying to figure out what the problem is. They've treated it many different ways. They still don't have a cure. It's not totally clear why it happens, if it's associated with flu, if it's associated with streptococcus, strep throat, and high temperatures that come with those illnesses. I was really surprised by this. I think encephalitis lethargica was really overshadowed by Spanish flu and polio and a number of other things that happened throughout the time period that it really became most pronounced. We also came up on the Great Depression and the Dust Bowl. There were a lot of bad things going on, and it seems that this was kind of lost in the mix, maybe. Molly Caldwell Crosby found a lot of documentation that kind of took her all over the place. A lot of it was in England. A lot of it was in New York, also in Eastern Europe, in Austria, in Germany. She was able to dig through some of the doctor's notes over the years to find what the story was and what happened and why it could still be a threat in the future, because they don't know why it disappeared and they don't know why it happened in the first place. There's a lot of theories that this may have happened many years before too, and that the story of Sleeping Beauty is based off of encephalitis lethargica or something like that. So I found it really interesting. I was so happy that Diane got this for me. It was a surprise. It just came back from vacation, I think, and it was waiting on the front porch, and I didn't know she had ordered it. So I started reading it, and it was a pretty interesting, forgotten epidemic. That it is surprising and disturbing what it did. I would recommend this to anybody. I think it's a very interesting nonfiction book about a forgotten illness that could become a threat in the future. This is from 2010, but I think it's also interesting reading it during a pandemic. And I read it while I had COVID, although I have tested negative now. So I'm feeling pretty good about that. Feeling pretty good. Hello? Mr. President? Yes, well, I'm filming right now. I was just talking about encephalitis lethargica. Well, I think you should read the book. $1 million? Somebody wants to sponsor my channel for $1 million. They want me to monetize? Well, Mr. President, I can't do that. I said when I started this channel, I would not monetize and I would not be sponsored. And I'm going to stick to that. Yes, Mr. President, I can't. I will not do it. I have to stay true to myself and true to my 250,000 subscribers. Presidential Medal of Freedom? I can do that. Yes, Mr. President, I will accept the Presidential Medal of Freedom. I have 2 medals, and I'd love to add a 3rd medal. Well, thank you very much, Mr. President. I will continue to review books and do tags And I do thank you for the offer for millions of dollars and sponsorships and monetization, but I will not do it. Thank you, Mr. President. You have a good night too, and I hope that you watch this review of Asleep when you get the chance. You will. It's on your regular briefing each morning. Amazing. Thank you, Mr. President. No. Thank you for your call. It's okay. You can call anytime, even though you're interrupting me while I'm filming. Thank you. Have a good night. Bye. Sorry about that. I would read this if I were you to avoid encephalitis lethargica, because now I'm worried about getting it. I can't believe I got a call from the president. The dream come true. Getting the Presidential Medal of Freedom. A dream come true. So much better than my other medals. Thanks for being here today. I will see you later.
In the middle of the night, I go walking in my sleep. From the mountains of fame to the river so deep. I must be looking for something. Something sacred I lost. But the river is wide, and it's too hard to cross.
Dream,
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 dream. Subscribe.